Let us remember we are in the holy presence of God. He was a Belgian priest, a cosmologist, an astronomer, and a mathematician. Father Georges Lemaitre earned a PhD in mathematics from the University of Leuven in Belgium in 1920, and he was ordained a diocesan priest 3 years later in 1923. He went on to earn advanced degrees at Cambridge under the direction of the great scientist Sir Arthur Eddington, at Harvard College Observatory in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. It was in 1927 that Father Lemaitre's work would begin to send shockwaves through the scientific world. That year, he published an article in French entitled "A Homogeneous Universe of Constant Mass and Growing Radius, Accounting for the Radial Velocity of Extragalactic Nebulae." He was the first scientist to propose the idea that the cosmos is expanding. When, with the help of Arthur Eddington, that article was translated into English 4 years later, his proposal got the attention of Albert Einstein and many other major scientists and mathematicians. Einstein initially refused to accept the idea of an expanding universe, and he told Lemaitre, "Your calculations are correct, but your physics is atrocious." At a conference in London in 1930, Lemaitre offered a further proposal that the universe expanded from an initial point, a singularity, which he called the primeval atom. He sometimes called this theory the cosmic egg exploding at the moment of creation. He was the first scientist to propose not only that the universe is expanding from an initial explosion, but that the rate of that expansion is actually accelerating. A British scientist named Fred Hoyle, who, like Einstein, was a stubborn proponent of the static, steady-state universe, went on BBC radio to mock Lemaitre's theory by sarcastically calling it the Big Bang Theory. Even Father Lemaitre's mentor, Sir Arthur Eddington, was unconvinced. Lemaitre had met Albert Einstein on three occasions, twice at conferences in Brussels and once at Princeton University in New Jersey. In 1935, the two men traveled to California for a series of conferences. After hearing Lemaitre fully explain his expanding universe theory, Einstein stood on his feet, applauded, and said, "This is the most beautiful and satisfactory explanation of creation to which I have ever listened." Using Einstein's own mathematical constructions, Lemaitre had changed Einstein's mind and convinced him that the steady-state universe was untenable, that the universe is indeed expanding. So Father Georges Lemaitre was, among other things, a pioneer in applying Einstein's theory of general relativity to cosmology. Although for a long time Edwin Hubble received credit for what became known as Hubble's Law, we now know that Lemaitre proposed it 2 years earlier. Since it was published in French, it didn't reach the English-speaking world for several years. For good reason, newspapers around the world began to call the Belgian priest the leader of the new cosmological physics. His work changed the course of cosmology. By the way, Lemaitre was a modest man who said it didn't bother him at all that Hubble was getting credit for his ideas. Lemaitre's most famous book on the subject was published in 1946, The Primeval Atom Hypothesis. Over the years, Georges Lemaitre received any number of honors, becoming a member of the Pontifical Academy of Sciences and the Belgian Royal Academy of Sciences and Arts, and receiving the Eddington Medal from the Royal Astronomical Society of Great Britain. Just before he died in 1966, Father Lemaitre learned of the discovery of cosmic microwave background radiation, which provided further evidence for his primeval atom theory. So, as the poster in the meme proclaims, if you like the Big Bang Theory, thank a priest. And by the way, if you are under the impression that Christian faith is hostile to and an enemy of science, that impression is wrong. It may be true for a small number of Christians who insist on interpreting every word of the Bible literally, but it has never been the case for mainstream Christians, including Roman Catholics. Along with Father Gregor Mendel and Father Teilhard de Chardin and thousands of other faithful Catholics involved in scientific research, Father George Lemaitre was a living example of the compatibility of reason and Christian faith, science, and religion. Let us pray. Lord, help us to see that we learn about you in many ways. We learn about you when we place our faith in the words of your prophets and the written scriptures which you inspire. And we learn about you by using reason and logic and the scientific method to probe more deeply into the cosmos you have created and continue to create. You, Lord, are the source of everything that is true and real. Help us to understand, as St. Augustine did, that what we know by faith and what we learn by reason cannot be in conflict. Continue to challenge each one of us to grow and to reach our potential, both spiritually and intellectually. St. John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever.